Below are the 10 problems that will be worked on this video. This is part 3 of complex numbers. So remember from parts 1 and 2, we defined I as the square root of negative 1. That's an imaginary number or the imaginary unit. I squared equals negative 1. If we have the square root of a negative number, we rewrote it as the square root of the positive number times I. And this is a little review of how to multiply square roots. You have to keep in mind whatever's underneath the square root must be positive. So as a simple review, put the video on pause and try these three problems. And then in this video, we're going to continue by adding, subtracting, and multiplying with complex numbers. Okay, let's work through these. For number one, I have the negative 2 on the outside, and I have a square root of a negative number on the inside. So remember, I could write that as I times the square root of 12. And then we'd have to simplify the square root of 12. So I could write that as 4 times 3, and a 2 then gets out. So we end up with, on the outside of the square root, negative 2 times 2, which is negative 4, I square roots of 3, or you could write that as negative 4 square roots of 3, I. Just make sure you don't have the I underneath the square root symbol. So both of these are correct. All right, what about number 2? Same thing, I have to begin by writing the square roots of negative numbers as the square root of the positive number times I. So this would be 3i square roots of 7 times 2i square roots of 14. Okay, so on the outside of the square root, I have 3 times 2, which is 6, and I have I times I, which is I squared, and now I can multiply the square root of 7 times the square root of 14. I can do 7 times 14, I'm going to leave it in factored form. 7 times 7 times 2. That way I could see for these two 7s, a 7 could come out, right? So that I end up with 6 times 7, 42, that's the 6 times 7. I squared is a negative 1, and underneath the square root all I have is the 2. Almost done. I just have to do the 42 times negative 1, so it's negative 42 square roots of 2. Right? So it's a little review of multiplying. Now we have division for number 3. Again, I want to rewrite each of those with an I. Now remember, I could put the I in front of the square root or behind it, but make sure it's not underneath the square root. Now if I write it behind it, notice the I's just cancel. They cancel out. So now I just have the square root of 40 over the square root of 5. That's the square root of 40 over 5. Well, what's the square root of 40 over 5? That's the same thing as the square root of 8. Now I have to simplify the square root of 8. So that's the square root of 4 times 2. I could take the square root of 4 out is a 2. And finally, I get my answer, 2 square roots of 2. So these are the kinds of problems we've done. So far, we were simplifying, we were multiplying, we were dividing when we had some square roots of negative numbers in the bottom, or you could have I's as well. And now we're going to add and subtract. To add complex numbers, like we have two complex numbers, a plus bi, and another one, c plus di, we simply add the real parts. Well, the real parts are the A and the C. That'll be the new real part. And then we add the imaginary parts, the BI plus DI. So you add the B plus D together. So here's an example. What if I had 3 minus 2i plus 6 plus 4i? We simply add the 3 and 6 together, which is going to be 9. And then we've got negative 2i and plus 4i, so I'm adding the negative 2 plus 4, and that'll give you a plus 2i. It's just like adding like terms, except that this is really a number. Remember that I is not a variable, it's actually a number, and I've written it in standard form, a plus bi. Now, the same thing goes for subtracting. Let's say instead of a plus sign there. What if it was 3 minus 2i minus 6 plus 4i? You're going to have to distribute the minus sign just like if it was an algebraic expression. So we'd have a minus 6 and a minus 4i. And now, again, we can add the real parts together. The 3 and the minus 6 will be negative 3. And then we've got negative 2i and minus 4i. That'll give you a negative 6i. So it's really not too hard to add or subtract when you have complex numbers. Now, when you put it in standard form, we mean a plus bi, but if your answer is something like this, 3 plus 2i plus negative 3 minus 5i, notice the 3 minus 3 is going to cancel, and 2i minus 5i is negative 3i. That's okay to leave it that way. You could put 0 minus 3i if you want to see the real part as being 0, but this is really a more simplified form. All right, moving on to multiplying complex numbers. Remember that I squared equals negative 1. You multiply just like you do when you're working with variables, except you do have to remember that I really is not a variable. So for this first one, I have negative 4i times 3i. We'll do the negative 4 times 3, which is negative 12i squared. But then what does I squared stand for? That's negative 1. So now I've got negative 12 times negative 1, which is 12. That's all there is to it. All right, let's look at the next one. By the way, you could always put the video on pause and try it on your own first. All right, let's just do the negative 5 times negative 2. That's 10i. We're done. That was an easy one. All right, what about this third one? Well, I've got to do the distributive property. So I'm going to have 3i times 5 plus 3i times 7i. And now within each of these, I have to simplify. So I have 3 times 5 is 15i. And what's going on over here? I've got 3 times 7, which is 21. And I times I is I squared. Here's the I squared again. So I have 15i plus 21 times negative 1. Now, when you have 21 times negative 1, that's going to be negative 21. That's going to be your real part. I'm just going to write that first, because to put it in standard form, we want to write the real part first. So that's negative 21 plus 15i. Okay, so basically, when you're multiplying complex numbers, it's very similar to multiplying algebraic expressions, but you're going to simplify if you see an I squared by writing that as a negative 1. All right, here's another multiplication, but this looks like two binomials. They're really just two complex numbers, but you multiply it out as if it were a binomial. So you could use the FOIL method or any other method you use for multiplying binomials. So try this on your own and see if you can get all the way to an answer in standard form. Okay, let's do it. So I'm going to do the first, outer, inner, last. So the first will be 2 times 6, I'm using FOIL, 12. The outer term, 2 times negative 5i, will be negative 10i. The inner term, 3i times 6, will be plus 18i. And the last term will be 3 times negative 5i, negative 15, but what do I have here? I have an I squared. All right. So I've got 12. Now, notice these two terms in the middle end up being the like terms as if they were variables, but really that means that's the imaginary parts. So I'm going to combine those. Negative 10 plus 18 will be a plus 8i. And what's going to go on over here? Let's see if we could do this in one step. I squared is negative 1. All right. So if you do negative 15 times negative 1, you're going to get plus 15. Basically, it's going to change the sign. So just keep in mind, the way I got that was negative 15 times negative 1. That's how I got that plus 15. And now we can add the 12 and the 15. So notice the first and the last term ended up being the real parts. The 12 plus 15 in this case will be 27, because I want to write the real part first, plus 8i. And there we go. And we'll do some more problems multiplying, and then we'll go on to dividing and doing powers of i's on the next video.